Cast your mind back to the year 2002. Pop stars The Rivals was on our TV screens and introduced us to a group of girls who were about to take the world by storm. Sound of the Underground was crowned Christmas number one that year and propelled Girls Aloud to stardom. Well, fast forward to 2024, and the girls are back for their first tour in more than 10 years. And it's safe to say they're looking forward to getting back on the road.
We start our rehearsals in just a few days' time now, so we can't wait to get in there with our dancers, get in the rehearsal space, get our bodies moving.
It's so exciting, isn't it? And it just feels very, very real now, but in a good way, in an exciting way.
It feels like everyone's really ready for this as well. Sometimes you have these like tours and like it's too soon, but this feels like it's just like the right time.
It does. It felt like that for us too. That's why we all agreed. It just felt like everything aligned for the first time in ages. I mean, we were planning to do something for the 20-year anniversary. It's now what, 22 years? Mm. 22 this year. Mm. So we knew we were ready to do something. It didn't feel right until now.
Are you nervous?
No. Not about the show. So many people keep saying to me, oh, how do you feel about like going back? I'm like, that's literally the bit I'm least worried about. It's funny, isn't it?
That's the
like,
best
the
bit
actual
about
performance
it.
Is like the least worrying part to me.
Yeah,
the logistics of having three kids on tour is way more stressful than actually getting up there and singing.
But now we're not having to worry about like, is there a single release? Is the record ready? Like, what are we going to do for this show, for this TV performance? Like, putting on tours was always our favourite part of the whole thing. And so without any of the other pressures, we can just thoroughly enjoy performing and putting on a fab show.
This is going to be the first tour without Sarah. Like, that's going to be obviously very hard for you, but at the same time, I imagine it will be like very emotional as well.
And something a little bit healing about it, I think, after the loss of her, we'll be taking her memory and honouring her in such a big way that I know for a fact she'll love.
Yeah.
She will love that we're placing her in the way we are and doing the things we're doing.
She deserves it.
Yeah.
And everything more, she really does.
It's hard, you know, it's hard for us. Like, people move on with their lives and they you know, they get on with life as you do. But, you know, she's still gone. You know, it's still really, really hard for us.
And
having
really
those moments
fresh.
Are important.
Yeah.
And it's still surreal, even anytime somebody brings it up.
So
I'm like,
surreal.
Oh, God, no. You'd hate being reminded of it. So they have to go and do shows every night
it
to
be
reminded
hard,
of that.
Yeah. It will be hard.
It's really going to be difficult.
I think it'll hit us at different times as well.
Like, I think that too.
One night it'll hit you, the next night it'll hit me, the next night.
It always hits you when you don't expect it.
But we get through a lot of it in rehearsals. Remember, we've got weeks of listening to it and getting familiar with it. The first night will be hard because the audience will then be brought in and it be their first experience of it, her not there. But then I think we can just honour her for the rest of it.
Well, Girls Aloud, thank you very much for chatting
to
us.
Thank
you. Have a great tour.
Thank you.